Jaya Jaya, what is best, solo processing or coupled processing? We're talking about coupling dynamics, tantric coupling dynamics. So when you feel like there is a trigger rising in your field right now, you know, you might be like, oh, fuck, I'm pissed, I'm angry. You enter into reactive mode because of something she said or something he said. And then you are like, okay, and then you go like, wow, you know, it really triggered me when you said that, and then you went into a process together, right? So that's one way to go that very often is going to bring to an escalation, and then suddenly you are in dissonance, fighting mode or something like that. So in a situation where suddenly you feel a trigger arising, it's really important to be intentional with what you do next. Just voicing what you feel to your partner might not be the best thing to do. Believe me, okay? Because suddenly you go into triggered mode, you are triggered, you are in a triggered place, and then you are going to say things that are not necessarily going to be received in the right way. So what you want is like, you feel the trigger, you feel that something is happening. The first thing is you pause, you stop, you observe what's happening. Okay, it's really important. Take a break, pause right there where you are. You just go like, and then you breathe. You see, you bring it into presence. You bring this trigger into presence so that you give space to that tiny emotion that just wants to blast out. You give it space, you allow it to be present. And then, once you start discovering that something is there, then most of the times, okay, probably 80% of the time, it's going to be way more useful if you step out of the field, out of the coupling field, and you go and process or transmute what's happening there by yourself. There are a lot of emotions and a lot of situations that can happen in relationships when couples, both partners, decide to process things together. But guess what? It accumulates things, and then suddenly, before you know it, you don't really have the tools to navigate that together. So what you want is to be like, I've got the trigger, I'm going to step out. What it looks like, for instance, if I have a partner in this space and she says something that is going to trigger me, I go like, ah, yeah, well, thank you for sharing your truth. Let me just take a break. I'm going to integrate what you said. And off I go to the river nearby, and I'm going to go there under the waterfall, and I'm going to digest these emotions, check what's inside, come back to my center, digest so that I don't come and project shit on her, okay? There is like a strategic way of navigating that is going to sustain connection rather than bring your fields into dissonance. So I go down there, I process what's happening, and then from an intentional place, you know, I come back and I might be clear. I might be back from a place where that's it, my field is clear. I'm back to an energetic space where I'm no longer in trigger zone. I'm no longer in trigger mode. I processed what I needed to process. I digested, transmuted. And maybe after that, there is a possibility that there is still something in the field that needs an adjustment. Maybe there is something that you want to share. And so this is called doing a shadow check. Okay, but it's not coming from a reactive mode, from a triggered place. It's like, listen, something has been happening between us over the last couple of days, and I would love to sit down with you to check in what's happening there, what's alive in the field for both of us. When would be a good time for us to sit down? So this is intentional communication. This is called a shadow check. You are going to sit down with your partner in a space that is safe, where you create the container, you make sure that you're not being disturbed by technology and stuff, and you just sit down and take a moment to share what's alive. You know, there is a way to set that up in a way that is going to be really intentional and effective. Okay, so we're going to go into this process or the shadow check sequence in another video, but for now, just understand that there is a lot of things that can emerge, a lot of emotions potentially that can emerge in your relationship that don't need to be processing together. So again, what is best? solo processing or solo integration or solo transmutation or try to do that in the relationship. And in probably 80% of the cases, it's better to do that by yourself. You don't have to expand these emotions into the coupling space. You don't need to project that into the coupling space, because most of the times when you are in trigger zone, when you are triggered, when there is something that is alive in your field, what you are going to voice, it's probably not going to be that mature. It's going to be charged. It's coming to a place of wounding or trauma, or, you know, there is something there that is not fully integrated. So when you communicate with your partner, ideally, if the goal is to create harmony, of course, if you want to be just in chaos and full on drama zone, that's possible as well. Just go for it. But if your goal is to go back to harmony, peace, connection, passion, and resonance with your partner, then most of the times it's better that you take a moment to come back to your center and do your own solo practice, your own shadow mastery practice. So it's solo processing rather than couple processing. So there is going to be certain situations where there is an agreement with your partner, where you agree with each other to go into intensity, to have, you know, a wild fight with each other, verbal fight. It can be, you know, physically playing. It can be like, it's okay to go that way, but you need two partners who know what they are doing, and it has to be intentional. Otherwise, you know, potentially your partner is going to, your couple is going to explode, and it's going to create a lot of pain for both of you. So when you want to go into intensity or shadow check or shadow mastery, shadow processing together, it needs to be done in a way that is intentional, where whether you understand the dynamics, you understand the sequences of what to go through, how to voice, how to express. Are you voicing together at the same time? Is it okay to go into intensity or not? How is your partner receiving it? Does that create connection? Does that create resonance or dissonance when you do that? Okay, so it's important to have some form of protocols or systems or sequences to navigate together. If you want to go together and do a coupling process together, then it's important to have some form of structure or some form of container to do that safely. Both options are available, but right now my hint to you is like, try to go a little bit more into solo integration rather than projecting that into your couple or into your partnership. Okay? Love you, and I'll see you soon.